Welcome to Puerto Vallarta.
So on a hot and humid day here in July in Puerto Vallarta, we want to take you on a little food excursion. So Puerto Vallarta is a food paradise. There's so many good restaurants around here, it's incredible. There's no way that we could possibly put all of the greatness into one video.
Absolutely not, no.
But we're gonna show you some of our favorites in this video, and we're gonna start it off with Perro Peru behind us. So behind me on the screens, they have a live shot of the kitchens.
You get a piece of fish and the juice all together, okay?
Well, this is gonna go down in history, my friend. Wow. That was very good. You might have just changed my fish.
So we're making your lomo saltado, second most popular dish in Peru. Okay? Here's oil. Peruvian lomo saltado.
So right now, we have just walked up to one of our many favorite taco places in Puerto Vallarta. It's a place called Pepe's, and it's one of our favorites, so we look forward to coming in, and I'm super excited about the tacos. They're famous for El Pastor.
El Pastor tacos are barbecued on the spit. It's a barbecued pork taco. You can see right behind us, they have the big spit. They're open late.
So I actually think they're open at least till 4 in the morning from what I understand. So a lot of people that go have some fun in Puerto Vallarta come down here for some after bar treats.
So we just ordered some El Pastor tacos here at Pepe's. Christine ordered the flour harina tacos. And I got the corn. So the corn.
I think I got the better deal. His are tiny.
Cost is 24 pesos for the corn and 48 pesos for the flour. So flour's a little more expensive, they're a little bigger, but.
I'm an expensive date today.
She's an expensive date always. Well, those were amazing. If you know of a better El Pastor taco place in Puerto Vallarta, other than Pepe's there, let us know in the comments down below, because it's gonna be pretty tough to beat those ones. And we've tried a lot in this town.
So we're currently at the restaurant called Martini O Fuego, and the owner is absolutely a true gem. Also the chef, I believe, in this restaurant. Now we've eaten here a couple of times in the past and had a fabulous experience. So if you do come to Puerto Vallarta, make sure that you come visit this place. It's just in the old city in the romantic song.
Let's go check it out.
So one of the first things you need to do when you come to Martini and Fuego is order a margarita, because it is one of the best in town.
So absolutely.
Start off your dinner with a beautiful margarita.
Handcrafted margarita. Cheers. So this is a tiger prawn dish that they was recommended to us as an appetizer. It comes with butter and garlic and fresh shrimp and the special Mexican pot that they cook it in. It came sizzling, and there's some serrano peppers in it. It looks just absolutely amazing. Can't wait to try it. We're currently just at one of our favorite taco places in Puerto Vallarta. It's called Maria Baja, and now it's just on one of the highways that goes past the romantic zone. I think it's called a Mapas area. So if you find it, it is a little tricky place to find, but it is just before the kiosco on the right hand side. If you come here, they have some of the best tacos we've had. So Maria Baja is also known for their homemade salsas. They hand make here, and it's something that's a little bit more unique than some of the places we've been to, because there's several different flavors. I ordered a jicama camaroni taco. So it's shrimp deep fried in a special batter with some type of sauce sprinkled with jalapenos and pineapple and pico de gallo of some sort. And the shell is actually like shaved from a plant called jicama. They thinly shave it, so it's a vegetable, so it's a nice alternative. This is the Baja shrimp taco. So it comes with a nice little shell and some shrimp that is deep fried and some type of little special sauce, but it is so tasty. I can't wait. Tuna mango tostada that they make here is special, and Jim's super excited about this one as well. Looks like it's got mango, some type of little seeds, some fresh tuna, and some fresh tostada shells. It's great. So one thing I'm drinking is called a agua fresca. This one happens to be pineapple, chia seeds, and cucumber.
So other than the noise when you're eating, Maria Baja never disappoints, so that is a place to come and is one of the best taco places you're going to find here in Puerto Vallarta. So just down in Emilio Zapata area, there's a great artist district, and one of the places that you should check out is a place called Culture. It's a restaurant, bar, gallery. They have happy hour from 4 to 7 every day, but they showcase a lot of the local artist work, and it's just a beautiful place. So I'll show you inside. They got some great drinks. You can check out the local artist's work while you're sitting and having a cocktail or some dinner. They also have a coffee shop as well. So another one of the must stops here in Puerto Vallarta, if you're a pizza lover, is Los Muertos Brewing. They have amazing beer, craft beer, plus they have amazing pizza. We're just on the same street as the pier, so just up from the pier is one of our favorite quesadilla places. It's called Tacos El Canada. Just a great place for some cheap eats for some quesadillas, and they have a whole bunch of different options for you. They've been around here for over 30 years. It's a family-run business. If you're in the mood for some good quesadillas, this is a place to come and check out.
So we're back at one of our favorite restaurants down near, just off the Malecon actually, and it's called Nocinada. We talked about this before. We came for some happy hour. We've been here in past years and wonderful experiences. But tonight we're back, and tonight we have ordered two wonderful dishes. Jim has ordered the red snapper, and I have ordered what's called a tequila shrimp. And super excited for tonight's dinner. If you're gonna come to Puerto Vallarta, it's a must place to visit, and the staff are absolutely lovely and wonderful.
For all you chocolate lovers, Choco Diva, right here in the Zona Romantica. It is amazing. It's wine, restaurant, chocolate, coffee shop, you name it, they got it. Come down and check it out. So a little bit off the beaten path here in Puerto Vallarta is called Ernesto's Good Grub. They have a location in Puerto Vallarta, and they have a location in Nuevo Vallarta. So either place you're staying, you can find this place. It has the best tortilla soup in town, and you will not be disappointed. They also have all-you-can-eat ribs on Thursdays, and their ribs are fantastic. So if you get a chance to come to Ernesto's Good Grub, take it, because you won't be disappointed. The food is always awesome.
This is the best tortilla soup that I think I've ever had. So it's a Saturday, and we're downtown Puerto Vallarta, just off the Malecon, and we've come to this famous park to see the Mango Festival. So we'll take you through the festival, and we'll see what it's all about, see what we see. Looks fun.
So I just got some mango atún ceviche from Barcelona Tapas here in the Mango Festival. I got some spicy sauce on it. It's local yellowfin tuna. I'm gonna just give it a shot. Bueno. Wow. Super spicy, because I asked for the spice. That tuna just melts in your mouth, so it's excellent. So one of our favorite El Pastor tacos is from Sonorita Tacos. We just picked up a couple El Pastors, and they look amazing. They're gonna be great. So I just got a agua chili mango tostada from Andale's right here. Excellent. So agua chili is like a raw shrimp that basically cooks itself in lime juice. So it's not everyone's cup of tea, because it is raw, but when you combine it with mango and the lime, it's just absolutely amazing. So, Andale's restaurant and bar.
Thank you very much.
Hi, welcome. Have a day.
Yeah.